Hi, I'm Jonathan Marks from New Brain Nutrition and Eat to Be Nice, and I'm here with Dr. Alejandro Arias Vasquez, PhD. He's the coordinator of the Eat to Be Nice program. He's also the director of the multifactorial lab from the Department of Human Genetics and Psychiatry at Radboud Medical Center in Nijmegen, the Netherlands. Can you give us an overview, doctor, about the Eat to Be Nice project?
Of course. Eat to Be Nice is a international European consortium funded by the EU that has three main aims. Basically, we want to identify nutritional factors that drive human behavior. That's the overarching goal. It's the main purpose of the project. Second, we want to identify what are the mechanisms involved in this relationship between nutrition, so food, and the way your brain is working. And third, once we get that information, we learn from that, we want to share it with everybody. We want to disseminate our findings to clinicians, to patients, to family members, to patient organizations, to the public, policymakers. So we want to be sure that when you hear that food is good for your brain, that you there's actual science backing that.
Great. And can you give us an overview of how this research will be done?
The project is set up in a way that there are multiple partners involved. We have 20 partners. And we cover different areas of research and education. So one main area of research is through clinical trials, where we will test specific dietary products, specific nutritional interventions, where we will test probiotics, vitamin and nutrient supplementation, Mediterranean diet, this famous diet from Spain. We will test special energy-restricted diets. And we will try to determine how these diets affect brain functioning in the way that they could improve, for example, patient symptomatology and make them feel better, actually. That's one way. Another way is that we are going to collect the poop, the feces from patients and participants in the study, and we're going to extract the bacteria DNA that lives in that poop. And we're going to sequence that DNA, and with that information, we will be able to determine what type of bacteria lives in your gut and if there is any difference in how much and what type of bacteria do patients have that is different from that people that are not affected. In that way, we can identify some of the mechanisms involved in this relationship between nutrition and the brain. And then the third one, and I said it before, we want to educate people. We want to help them eat better. We want to help them understand that through the way they eat, they can help their bodies in different ways, not only to be leaner or to be healthier, but specifically through how your brain is working.
And so there's a lot of information already out on the internet about many of these different protocols and diets. What makes this project important?
Well, there is one main difference between many of the things that are out there and Eat to Be Nice. Basically, that our results are backed up by hardcore science. So none of our results or our recommendations will come out of any commercial necessity or any private intentions or anything like that. Everything that will come out from Eat to Be Nice will be backed up by scientific results that are reliable, replicable, and available freely for everybody who's interested.
And why is the EU funding this project?
Well, the EU, through its food safety division, opened a call in 2016 in which they wanted to help the community identify ways to be healthier. And one of them is through nutrition, through what we eat. So they're really interested in identifying how food can help us in multiple ways. And the way we propose to do this is through investigating how nutrition can help people that have not necessarily a disease, but still that there are a higher risk for being ill. So the EU is very interested in identifying how food or eating patterns can be beneficial at multiple levels for the community, for the population.
And this study is also going to include tests on exercise and effects on the brain of exercise as well?
Of course, we cannot think about nutrition on its own, right? Because what we eat and how much we eat is also linked to what we do, how we behave in terms of our physical activity, our lifestyle choices. These things are not disconnected. So it offers the opportunity to investigate nutritional factors, nutritional behaviors, let's say the way we eat, in combination with how we move, physical activity, exercise, and how that interaction can help us actually improve our health status even more, and how that interaction can help us understand the mechanisms that are behind those changes at the brain level.
So we've been talking with Dr. Alejandro Arias Vasquez, PhD. He's again the coordinator of Eat to Be Nice and New Brain Nutrition. My name is Jonathan Marks with New Brain Nutrition, and we want to thank you for being with us today.
Thank you. My pleasure.